day viewers, welcome to Cybertech Arena. In this video, I'll be walking you through a tool called SEToolkit and how it's used. This is a tool most hackers use, they misuse. So before we proceed, hacking is illegal. If you must hack, do it ethically and do it with appropriate permission, and no information in this video should be misused. Okay, I will not be held liable. So to install SEToolkit, you use a command sudo apt get install SEToolkit. So another way you can do it, which is the easiest way, if you don't want to go through the command, it's just type SEToolkit, SETOOLKIT. Okay, then it's just going to ask you if you want to install SEToolkit. You're going to say yes. So I already have SEToolkit installed, so that's why mine won't show that. Okay, so let's move on. You all know what email spoofing is. Okay, email spoofing, it's a technique used by cyber criminals to send email, okay, so it appears like it's coming from a legitimate source. To fire up SEToolkit, you use the SEToolkit and to open SETOOLKIT. It's going to open. So here's the options we have here. So number one, social engineering attack. So that's the one we'll be using for this demonstration. So I'm going to choose one for this demonstration. So there's a whole lot you can do with SEToolkit. Okay, but with time I'll walk you through other things you can do with SEToolkit, but for this demonstration we are going to stick to this thing, number one, which is social engineering attack. Okay, so now we have options after you've choose number one. So we choose number five. Here you're going to be asked if the email, single email address, mass email. So this is where your hackers use the mass email, though you can use mass email to send email to if you have a large customer base or clients. Okay, so I'll use number one, single email, for this demonstration. Predefined template, I'll use number two, which is one time email template, meaning we are going to write it out. Predefined is like other emails there where you can choose from. So the subject, you can use whatever subject you like. I use hello world. Send message as HTML or plain, so I'll use plain. Enter the body of the message, so you type whatever you want to type and you put it, even you want to put anything. So the hackers will also include a link there. Okay, I just type hello testing. So when you are done, you hit enter. On a new line, you type end, END in capital letter. Send email to, that's the person you want them to receive the email. So I created a temporary email, so for this demonstration, so I'll paste it here. So if you use the one to send to too many people, you're going to see they will ask you to upload the file. Okay, number two, use our own server or open relay. Okay, so that's what we're going to choose here, which is number two. So from here, from email address, this is the person's email you want to see it as. So this is very important. This is where the hackers always put any email. I will tell you how to stop that at the end of the video, so stay tuned. This is where they put maybe your boss's email, so it looks like your boss is sending you an email. So I just use my email here for this demonstration. Okay, I use my email at gmail.com. The from name, so this is also where they are going to put your boss's name. So that's why you just have to be very careful online, and watch the emails you receive. How to, you be very careful with it. So I'll use my name here, Collins. Okay, user open relay. So this information will be gotten from the SMTP service. Okay, so there's a video I already created how to check those to check if an email is authentic. So I'll put the link also. So now I'll be using this SMTP service. It's formerly known as Sending Blue. So now they are called Bravo. Okay, so I already created an account. It's easy, create a free account so you can use it for this demonstration. So if you want to use it for your company, let's say you guys want to send an email, you don't have to pay for a sender. Again, you can just use it as your SMTP. Okay, you click on SMTP and API. So here you're going to see the details you need. This is your details, and I think we are allowed to send about 300 emails a day free. Okay, if you're facing any difficulty trying this out, you put in the comment section and I will respond within 24 to 48 hours. So this is the username they're asking us, which is the login. So I'll copy it and I'll paste it here. So the password for the open relay, the password is down here. Okay, here's mine. So I'll copy it. Okay, then I'll paste it here. SMTP email server address is also there. This is it, smtp-relay.brevo.com. I'll copy it. I'll paste it here also. Then the port here, 587. Flag this message high priority. Yes. Do you want to attach a file? I don't want to attach any file. The hackers might want to attach files also. So you be careful what you click online. Do you want to attach inline file? No. So let's wait and see. You can see set has finished sending. So let's go to check the email, the one I used, the one I created in the temp mule for this demonstration, and see if we receive the email there. So this is it. Then the inbox, as you can see, this is the email. We received it. Okay, so like I said earlier, to prevent spoofing, organizations can implement email authentication protocols like SPF, DKIM, and DMARC, as discussed. DMARC, these protocols help verify the legitimacy of the sender and reduce the likelihood that spoof emails will reach their intended target. Okay, so this video is already so long, so I'll be linking the description in the description how you can check if these emails are the email you receive, if it's authentic. Okay, I made a video earlier on, so you go check it out, how to check if emails are authentic. So if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, like, share this video, okay, so it's could reach to more people. You can also comment where you're watching from so we know each other. Thank you.